Britain's fashion frock-ups, makeup massacres, and horrific hair scares beware. 100% Hotter is coming to make you under.
Okay, cool, that's a lot to take in.
Our team of style supremos, Grace, Daniel, and Melissa, are waiting in the hotspot to help the underdressed.
Have you got a bra on?
No.
The fake obsessed.
Just
no,
breathe.
Stop.
Boing, 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 boing.
And the downright frightening.
You kind of scare me a little bit.
They may think they look hot.
Yeah, I love my look.
I look great.
I love it.
But the public says not.
3 out of 10.
2 out of 10.
1 out of 10.
It's time to transform these fashion disasters.
Why is it green?
white.
Into style masters.
3, 2, 1.
I love it.
Amazing.
You look great.
She's really beautiful.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10.
But can we make them 100% hotter? Tonight, two cases of extreme colour crisis. One whose mahogany madness is taking things a shade too far, and another whose pastel palette is washing out her work aspirations. It's time to reverse the rainbow and start afresh.
Dan, you're looking buff. You've been working out.
I've been working out.
You look really good.
Thank you so much.
Tell us your secret.
My secret to life is a little bit of stretching.
Oh, no, he's going to stretch.
Here we go.
Don't fall over.
Oh!
Oh, it's a good one!
And now I'm ready.
It's ready for anything.
Now I'm ready for the day.
Right, listen, less about you, Daniel. Let's find out who's up next in the hotspot.
Yes.
Abby wears so much fake tan, it's just ridiculous. She takes so long to do her makeup, she's just not spontaneous anymore. Everything that Abby wears is fake. Her fake tan, the hair, it's just crazy. I'm not a fan of Abby's skimpy clothing. When I saw this for the first time, I actually wondered if this was for a child. It's just attracting the wrong type of attention. Abby is such a pretty girl under all that makeup. I want the real Abby back. She needs your help.
Oh. She's just a shade of tangerine.
Tangerine.
She looks like a caricature.
Yeah, the contouring is really, really bad.
Yeah.
Can't stop looking at the puppies. Hi. They're so there.
They're real, so.
They're real?
Yeah.
Well,
wow, that's a lot.
Good.
Thanks,
on you.
Mama.
Your dad nominated you.
Yeah.
How did you feel about that?
Okay. He obviously doesn't like my look, so.
Does he comment on it all the time?
He hates it. But I love the way I look. It's me. It's Barbie, so.
It's definitely Barbie.
Yeah.
You've clearly had like a sunbed as well, yeah?
No, just pure fake tan.
This is just fake
this
tan.
This is just piles over piles.
Wow.
So how often are we talking?
Twice a day.
Twice a day?
Yeah.
Fake tan?
Yeah.
Your dress is getting dirty already. Does this happen to all your clothes?
Yeah,
like, immediately?
All my white clothes have to be pretty much bleached every day.
So bad for the environment.
I know.
It's probably really bad for you as
well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can we please talk about these tights?
Yeah, I don't like my legs.
Are they like 100 denier?
No, they're just really dark.
Hold on. We need to rewind. I don't like my legs, but I always have them on show.
Yeah, but with tan and tights and everything, they can't be bare and pale and no.
And the hair, what's going on there?
So I have two weaves on.
So they just yank out, yeah?
Yeah, I've got them gripped in, but literally...
So you don't wake up like this?
No, I do not wake up like this. I have really short hair, it's all in a bob, like, in a bun.
Talk me through your makeup.
Okay, so
where
it takes
you going
me
with
3 hours to get ready.
No!
Yeah.
That's like being in prison.
Yeah. The whole regime of having to do it every single day, waking up, putting on so much makeup, contouring, eyelashes, lipstick. I get called Barbie Bouncer because I'm actually a door woman.
Ah.
Because obviously I'm supposed to be this big, tough door woman, and I look like this on the door. So big hair, big makeup, big eyelashes, absolutely everything, so.
I can't believe that Abby works as a bouncer, yet looks like a Barbie. We need to get that over-the-top club look kicked out for sure.
So with all that fake tan, all that hair, and taking 3 hours to get ready, how much money do you think you spend on a monthly?
£500 a month.
Easy. £500?
That's yes. like a mortgage. You uh-huh. could buy a house.
£500 to spend.
Yeah, £500 a month. I don't like being natural. I don't like being so pale. And I don't think I've ever found a way to be myself.
So it's like a confidence thing.
Yeah, 100%. I don't know how to be pale. I've tried and it doesn't work. Yeah. I still end up this colour.
Abby comes across as so confident, but strangely, she's too scared to be her natural self. We need to fix those insecurities.
We asked the public to rate your look. Do you want to find out what they said?
OK.
I do.
I don't even know with this.
Way too much fake tan.
I'm instantly getting a bit of a vibe that she's a bit outgoing.
I think she's got too much fake tan on, too much extensions, and too much mascara on her eyes.
You can tell her extensions are fake, and that's really not a good look.
You can't even see her real eyebrow shape.
I feel harsh saying this. She seems a bit fake.
I'd rate this girl's look out of 10 a 3.
5 out of 10.
What, a 5 out of 10?
5 out of 10.
Abby, what do you think of that?
That's horrible. It's literally horrible. Oh. I like my fake tan, but...
Clearly.
Well, we did ask loads of people across the country, and I've got an average of your score, and...
Breathe.
It was a 4 out of 10.
Oh, maybe I need a change.
Oh, bless you.
Yeah.
First things first, though.
You might not like this. I am going to ask you to remove your makeup. Oh, my God. OK. Yeah.
Good.
Let's do it.
Here you go, Barbie.
Thank you.
Do me a favour. The first thing I want to see is where your eyebrows are at, so please take them off for me.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
See this? Oh, no.
The first step is not drawing eyebrows on that make you look masculine.
OK. Really?
Yeah. Those are falsies, aren't they? On your mm-hmm. eyes? Yeah?
Yeah, they're not real.
Bye bye, Barbie!
Hey!
I just see all this like ashy, grey tones coming off and seeing like beautiful skin underneath.
I don't feel it. I just feel really like pale and I don't know, plain.
No.
No.
Nah!
Are you sure?
I won't have it!
I won't.
You are no plain Jane. No way.
Yeah, we just see potential. Look at these wipes. There's so much.
So we have a little challenge for you.
Okay.
So turn around for me and walk out that door and we'll see you soon.
Okay.
Have fun.
Bye, Abby.
Coming up, will bubbly bouncer Abby be able to overcome her tan obsession?
This can't be a week's worth of fake tan, right? Surely.
And the style team meet a student whose soft shades are stopping her from being taken seriously.
I don't see it as childish.
You look like a toddler.
Earlier, we met nightclub security guard Abby.
Can't stop looking at the puppies.
Whose over-the-top makeup and dress sense had put her at the back of the style queue.
Takes me 3 hours to get ready.
No!
Yeah.
That's like being in prison.
After getting her back to basics, we've set Abby a tantastic challenge to help her realise the extent of her obsession.
Good grief. Where's your makeup?
I have no makeup on.
So pretty.
Really?
I don't think I've ever seen you without makeup.
So apparently you have my challenge. I've got a challenge to do.
And this is it.
Okay, let's do it. Abby, we know you love to cover yourself in fake tan, but do you actually know how much fake tan you use a week? Your challenge is to see how much of our wall you can paint using a week's worth of your fake tan. Will it cover the whole wall? There's only one way to find out. Good luck. Oh, my God.
Come on in.
I don't think it's going to be bigger.
OK, Abby, we'd better get this going.
Come on, then.
Oh my God, it's just never ending. I think we're gonna need a bigger wall. This can't be a week's worth of fake tan, right? Surely.
I can't believe you wear this mount.
This is not true. This can't be this much. I'm actually this colour. This is the funny thing. I'm actually shocked. Right, that's the whole wall. I can't believe we have covered it.
What do you think, Abby?
That's ridiculous.
That's what you put on your body each week. Do you think it's time to tone down?
Yeah, can I rub myself in it first?
This was a great challenge for Abby because she didn't appreciate how much fake tan she was using, and to paint a wall such as this is a great representation, and it's a visual imagery that Abby will hopefully take away with her.
I can't believe that is the colour of my skin. That's horrible. Here we go out looking that orange. I need to calm it down because that's just ridiculous. So, style team, you're correct. I need to stop fake tanning. That's crazy.
Yeah,
oh,
let's
my
go.
God.
Remember, like, back in the 90s when instead of using foils, you used to put caps on people
and pull hair through. Oh, God, yeah.
Like, to get highlights.
Barbaric.
So I was doing it, I pulled it through, I put on the bleach, I put the bleach all the way through, like, I was doing a gold star job, I wrapped it up in plastic, I put it under the machine, job well done. Half an hour later, come back. I pull off the cap, and every single bit of hair that I've ripped, pulled through the cap, has come off in the cap. So she's left with, like, hair this long and then long bits. It was like this. It wasn't a good day.
Did you get fired?
No, because I wasn't qualified.
Right, should we see who's in today?
Why not?
Da, da, da.
Phoenix is obsessed with Japanese culture and fashion, especially pastel. Phoenix has a lot of piercings. She's been bleaching her hair for years. She also decorates her face with stickers. She's actually averse to wearing dresses. But she wears these out.
I wonder if the nappy comes with that.
Technically, these are pajamas. Phoenix has a collection of these. She's looking for a job at the moment, and it'd be great if somebody could show her that there is an alternative and she can look great in a different style. Less piercings, neutral hair, natural makeup. Wearing something a bit more toned down, something like a professional-looking suit.
I don't think a suit's the way forward.
No. Like, all I saw was pastel pink, like it was a two-year-old girl's bedroom. I really want you to strip all the colour off her and just put her in black.
Oh, I would love to put her all in black. But I think that would be a real shock. I think we've kind of got to introduce elements of what she does and teach her how to grow up a bit.
Oh, yes. This is so good for you. I can't wait to see what you dress her in.
Yeah, I'm excited about this.
Yeah.
So you're Phoenix?
Yeah, I'm Phoenix.
Nice to meet you.
And you like the colour pink?
I really like the colour pink.
Talk us through the outfit.
So this is like a Japanese street fashion called Fairy K, and it's kind of based on like pastel colours, but I kind of like have like an androgynous kind of feel to it.
Mm.
Is that what the boy thing's about?
Yeah, that's partly of it. Like, also I just really like this jumper.
But I wouldn't put it with like, what would you call these?
I don't even know. They're just kind of like bloomer shorts kind of thing.
Mm. Knickerbockers. Pajamas.
They're not very flattering though, are they?
Oh, I like them. I like, they cover up my thighs.
Ah, okay, yeah. Cool.
So you're not comfortable with your thighs?
No, I've got a very, like, flowy figure, and this kind of, like, makes it less feminine.
Oh, so you don't want to look curvy?
No.
And you don't want to look feminine?
No. I just don't feel like that's me at all, and I just would feel weird dressing overly feminine.
In a way, this is very feminine, but very childish.
I don't see it as childish. I just see it as a kind of a street fashion.
You look like a toddler.
It's okay, I don't mind.
But you don't want to look like a grown-up?
It's not that I don't want to look like a grown-up, it's just that I want to maintain a kind of, like, fun kind of energy. I feel like kind of natural colours kind of bring me down a little bit.
I've got to ask you about those eyebrows. Wow.
There's eyebrows there, though.
Yeah, they're there.
They're there.
I'm happy they're there, because I'm the one that's going to have to, you know, do that face up, so I need the brow.
You are very cute, though.
Thank you.
What are people's reactions to you?
It depends on the situation. I wouldn't feel that I'd be taken seriously in, like, kind of a professional setting.
Yeah. I can see why Phoenix isn't always taken seriously, because she does look like a big baby. And let's face it, the white crayon eyeliner and multicoloured brows aren't helping. But now that she's inside the hotspot, playtime is over.
What do you do right now?
So I'm literally just graduating from university, so I'm just kind of finalising my last year.
And what did you graduate in?
I studied Japanese.
Ah, funny that.
Nihama. Is that Japanese?
That's Chinese.
Phoenix, we want to strip this all away from you.
Yeah.
But stripping it away is going to, like, bring out, like, obviously, like, the woman.
We'll see what happens.
Yeah? So you're comfortable with us to go down that avenue?
Just whatever happens, happens.
Yes.
Right, well, enough from us. We've asked the public to rate your look.
Sure.
Would you like to see it?
Sure, go crazy.
Come on then.
Oh, my God. Is this for real?
OK, I'd say they look quite like a little girl, actually.
The socks, I don't even know. I don't even have any words for that.
She looks like she's trying to live her childhood in her adult life.
I've got no idea what she actually looks like. It masks everything personal about her.
This is my personality, though.
I don't think a lot of places would hire her for looking like that.
She looks like she's a pretty girl. I would score her quite high, but her outfit, like, brings it right down to probably a 1 out of 10.
I would rate this girl's look about 4 out of 10.
5 out of 10?
Like a 2. If I was to rate her out of 10, I'd give her about a 2.
Wow.
Deep breath. How do you feel?
There are some, like, nasty comments like that sometimes, but at the same time, like, people think what they want.
Well, we asked people across the country to rate your look, and we made an average, and the score was 2.9 out of 10.
Yeah, that's fine by me.
Yeah, but we don't want you to look average. You don't want to look average either. We want you to look excellent, but to everybody.
It literally depends on what you think, like, looks good, your own, like, personal opinion. Like, I can't change my personality to change a number.
We don't want to change your personality. But your mum's nominated you because you're going for interviews and stuff like that. We just want everybody to think you look great.
You only get one chance to make a first impression.
So, in the meantime, we need to see what's underneath here a bit.
Mm. OK.
I'm going to ask you to take off some of your makeup now. Maybe start with the brows, because they are offending me just a little bit.
Are they?
Yeah.
And I'm just going to take this from you, and I'm just going to take that.
It's really nice to see a bit of you coming through, and I cannot wait to get you out of this pastel. So we've got a little bit of a challenge, which is going to be the first major step towards that happening. So off you go.
All right. Bye, guys.
Have fun.
Toodles.
Catch you later.
Hello, Phoenix.
Hey, Mom.
I've got the challenge. Shall we see what it is?
Sure, let's do this. Shred it. Phoenix, we know that you have a passion for pastels, but we think it's time for a change. So to kickstart your new wardrobe, we are telling you to trash some of your favourite outfits. However, rather than throwing them in the bin, you'll be throwing them into our industrial shredder.
Oh.
So there's no going back. Good luck, the style team.
Should we get going then?
Yeah, let's do this.
Come on, let's do it.
Hi. Yeah, you're Lizzie, yeah?
Hi, Terry.
Hi, Lizzie.
Phoenix. Hi, Phoenix.
Yeah. Welcome to our shredding company. I understand you've got something for me. Do you really want to let go of that?
Give it a try.
OK, right.
Pretty hard for me.
Enjoy this, because it looks like it's going to be the last time you're in pink.
OK, shall I do this?
It'll be all right.
One more hug. Have fun in your new life. Can't believe I just had to do that.
I can't wait to see the new you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you never wear it now, would you?
Oh, my God.
This will already be recycled now.
Yeah, I guess it was all right. At least it's going somewhere good.
Abby thinks that wearing revealing dresses and pastel shades makes her look feminine. but to lose the dolly look, what she actually needs is some edgier styling. I want to take her from ice cream to ice cool.
Hiya.
Oh, hey, how you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Welcome back to the hotspot.
Thank you.
Take a pew. By the way, it's really nice seeing you looking like a normal colour.
It's so pale, it's so pale. It's okay, it's okay. I'm kind of getting used to it.
So how did you find the challenge?
I had to paint a wall with a week's worth of my fake tan, which was quite interesting. I don't think I realised how much I wore.
Amazing. So that's job number one done.
Yay.
Now, I wanted to talk about, like, your body shape and your wardrobe, because you are a really strong, athletic figure.
Yeah, I mean, obviously I'm a bouncer. So I have to...
You have to be fit and strong for being a bouncer.
Yeah, you have to, yeah.
Because otherwise you'd be like... bitch slapping people.
Literally. Literally. So you have to do... It's quite intense. So, like, shoulders, back, legs is, like, a routine I do every week.
Do you find it a struggle to find things to fit?
100%. I struggle with jeans, I struggle with leggings, I struggle with tops because I've got a smaller waist as well. Mm. So I struggle to have particular tops to fit me that don't bag underneath.
So is that why you kind of rely on very... tight stretch things.
100%, yeah.
So I've got some things up here on the magic mirror that I hope will help you to have different options without having just to go the skin tight way.
That'd be amazing.
Okay, step up here. Okay, so I'm gonna start with these luscious legs because when you arrived, you were wearing a short dress and yet you said to me you don't like getting your legs out.
I had tan and tights on though.
Okay, so the tan and the tights must be a bit of a rigmarole, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I've chosen a jumpsuit, which in like a silky flowing fabric can still help you look feminine, but also just like chuck it on.
That'd be amazing.
Now this is brilliant.
I love it.
This is called, do you?
Yeah,
hey,
this
Resolved!
Is amazing.
This is called an illusion dress. So it's black on the outside and then it's white in the middle because that's the bit that people look at. So you draw their eye to a small point on your waist and because it's got white here, it makes your waist look like this big because that's where people's eyes draw to. And also for you, those fingerprints with all of that fake tan that were going all over your dress, at least if you're gonna fake tan, you're not gonna get it on the majority of your dress.
Yeah, I don't want to fake tan any more white clothes.
Yes, we've taught her something! Right, well, speaking of that, I'm gonna send you off to the Glam Squad to properly show you how to do this.
Okay,
see you later.
Still to come.
A lot of it fell out through bleach.
Can the style team prevent another peroxide nightmare?
It looks like a mullet.
Plus, Phoenix's new look takes flight.
No peeking. Okay, so this is it.
Earlier, we met Abby.
How you doing?
A club security guard and a fake tan fanatic with a passion for peroxide. After having her wardrobe dissected by Grace, it's time for Mel and Daniel to get stuck in.
That looks so much better. I need some hairspray.
I am so excited about Abby.
You are?
She's so bubbly.
She's so bubbly.
Yeah.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, good, how are you?
Good.
A little bit nervous.
Take
Don't
a seat.
Be nervous.
Thanks. Let's have a look.
Oh, God.
So this is just you?
This is me. This is my natural
100%.
Hair. It looks like a mullet.
It does look like a mullet.
A lot of it fell out through bleach.
So are you prepared to stop that process of bleaching it?
I want my hair to be in
essentially
better condition.
The only way that you're going to grow your hair and have it into a state that is somewhat wearable is if you stop bleaching it.
Yeah.
Period.
Yeah.
No compromise.
Okay.
I don't have a problem with hair extensions. I think they're great for what they are, but I don't think it's an everyday kind of thing.
Yeah.
I'd like you to be able to feel not committed to wearing them. So wearing them of an evening or wearing them if you're going out to party, but wearing them to the gym and wearing them to do the grocery shopping is a little bit much.
It's a bit too much.
And I mean, the combination of the bleach and the hair extensions is going to give you... That's going to be
a
never-ending, vicious story. At the end of the day, it's all fixable. It's just about having patience and about looking after it in the right way. Well, I've got to go prepare myself for what's going to happen today. So, over to Mel.
Thank you
And
so
I will
much.
See you in a bit.
Hello.
Hello.
Hey, hey.
I've been really excited about you.
Yay!
I need help.
Tell me, talk to me.
I need help. I do love contour.
Yeah.
But I don't know how to contour the correct way, whether it's over foundation, under foundation. I think everyone has a different way of doing
it. They do,
it,
yeah.
And it's the right way that I want to do.
Okay, because when I first saw you, I noticed that you're obviously using a concealer that is a lot lighter, aren't you?
Yeah.
And sometimes, where it's so light, it ends up looking a bit ashy.
Oh, okay.
Do you get what I mean? Because
yeah,
it has
yeah.
not much pigment in it.
Yeah.
So it's taken away, like, the natural colour of your skin tone.
Oh.
With contouring, it's not about going so light and dark and it being a massive drastic difference and trying to merge them together. Mm. It's about finding, like, a balance between the two tones. Looking at your actual face structure as well, you don't, like, you've got natural cheekbones, I can see them. You just need to work with them. There's a natural shadow around here. Can you see that as well?
Yeah. I've never really realised it before, I think. Yeah.
Sometimes piling on too much makeup actually takes away the dimension of your face. All right, so no more seeing yourself from this point.
While Mel and Daniel get to work on Abby's make-under, it's time for Grace to find out if Phoenix managed to shred all ties with her pastel obsession.
Hey, Phoenix,
Hey-ya.
How are you doing?
I'm okay, how are you doing?
Take a pew. So, you have been doing your challenge.
I have indeed.
Do you hate me for sending all of your pastel clothes to the Care Bears in the sky?
No, I'm okay with it.
Are you?
Yes. I've never shredded anything before, so I guess that was the fun side of it, really, seeing them come out in, like, little pieces.
I want to say to you, the subculture thing, I think it's really, really cool, but I worry, like we saw from the results earlier, that other people don't get it. You know they say in job interviews, they've made a judgment about you in the first 30 seconds, literally as you walk in the door. So that's what I want to work on, is making sure that that first impression that you give is just perfect. I want you to stand out. I want your creativity to be first and foremost. But I also don't want you to be misunderstood. There are different ways to do that without necessarily looking like... I just worry you look like a toddler. I really do.
I never really associated pastel colours with being a kid. I think my style is attached to my emotions and kind of my personality. It's all kind of integrated into one big ball of pastel. Sometimes, like, wearing a dress will literally just make me feel uncomfortable in myself and in my body. So that's probably why I avoid them.
Mm-mm. I mean, I'm not a girly girl, but I do wear dresses. I just choose a certain type.
Yeah.
Right. Well, I've got some stuff on the magic mirror. Hopefully, you'll like them. You ready for it?
Yeah, I'm ready for anything.
Come on, then. First, let's take this horrid T-shirt off. OK. I love these. What do you think? I know that your mum said she wanted you to wear a suit, so I'm trying to find this balance between a suit, which is not going to happen, and some, you know, something else that you could go to a job interview in or just kick about in and feel cool and comfortable.
Are they shorts or a skirt?
They are culottes.
So, looking at them on me now, I mean, it would depend on what I'd be wearing on the top as to how comfortable I would feeling them.
Well, why I love these is they give you some shape, but without being curvy, and they're not too girly, and they're the right length. But also, you put them with the right thing. This can be like business wear. It could be interview wear. It's about how you style it, what you put with it. Moving on from the culottes. Don't freak out. I like this one, right, because of the shape.
I really don't like that it is that, it's that curvy. I don't like the curve at all. It's too body tight for me. But I think if it was a little less, like, body tight, I mean, the rest of it seems okay.
I could convince you, perhaps, if this was straight up and down, it didn't have a waist, this might kind of work for you.
Possibly. Like, at the end of the day, it's still a dress, so I can't guarantee that I would be okay with it, but possibly.
You are going to be quite a task for me, young lady.
Sorry.
No, I think I've got a good idea in my head, but now is the fun bit. You need to go have your full hair and makeup done with lovely Daniel and Mel, okay?
Yes.
Come back when you're ready.
All right.
See you later.
All right, see you later.
You should come up with an eyeliner tip for the tube. How to apply liquid eyeliner on the tube.
See, I personally, if I was applying eyeliner on a tube, I would stick to a pencil.
Yeah,
that way you can soften it out.
Yeah.
trying to do something that's slick and neat and tidy.
At peak hour?
Nah.
Not happening?
Nah.
No.
Not feeling it.
Hey, Phoenix.
Hey, Phoenix.
Hello.
Welcome, welcome.
Take a seat for me. Should we do the magic spin?
Do the magic spin.
Hey! Maybe another one.
Okay. Ooh. So, let's talk makeup. You don't wear black mascara, do you?
Not really. People in the, like, Japanese fashion communities, they do actually wear a lot of, like, light black, especially with, like, eyelashes, but it's just something I never really did myself.
I actually want to apply a bit of mascara on you.
Good idea.
Yeah. I don't feel like you like a lot of volume or something, anything too over the top, so I just want to literally coat the lashes very lightly. If you look down for me and just go at the root, so, like, give it a little wiggle at the root, and just look up for me. I just feel like your eye looks so much prettier already.
Mm.
Like, you don't need much, but it's just those little things that are going to give the eyes a little bit of, like, a twinkle, like a bit of a sparkle. I don't feel like I need to do anything, like, dramatic to you, because I don't want to take away from, like, your personality and who you are and how you feel comfortable.
If it's makeup-wise, then I'm happy to experiment with that, for sure.
Because, you know, as well, like, it's nothing that's, like, forever. But it's something that you could really like. You don't know if you're gonna forever like pastel shades. Do you know what I mean? So I think I know what I'm gonna do with you, but I'm gonna pass you over now to Dan, and he's gonna talk through hair.
So I already have a vision of what I wanna do.
Yeah.
Which I'm not gonna tell you.
Yeah.
But what could be the worst thing that I could do to you, hair-wise?
Like, kind of the length it is now is probably about as long as I want it.
This is as long as you want to go?
Yeah.
Yeah? So you don't mind having it looking a little bit more androgynous and boy-like to a degree?
I want it more androgynous and boy-like.
You do?
Yeah, that's what I want.
Okay, awesome. That gives me something to work with. I mean, having this kind of colour hair, to a degree, it does work looking really dishevelled and messy. I do think that that works. But on the other hand, if you're wanting it to look a little bit healthier, then using a shine spray at home is going to be your best friend, basically.
Yeah.
Because blonde hair absorbs light.
Yeah.
And dark hair reflects light. So as soon as you sort of take your hair colour to this colour, it just sucks up light and looks matte and lifeless. Again, I don't really dislike it. It's not offensive to me, your hair. It kind of, like, works with your whole look. I just feel like it needs a little bit more refining. You know, you're a woman, not a high school student, so I think we can make it look a little cooler and edgier, but still, like, maintaining the essence of what it is.
Right. I mean, like, it sounds like what you want to do is something that I would be happy with, so...
Awesome.
Yeah, I'm trusting you.
You are?
Yeah.
Say it again.
I'm trusting you.
Yes. Awesome. Well, as I said, I've got a pretty clear vision, so let's get started.
Woo!
Phoenix's passion for pastels and Japanese subculture were making her look like a preschooler. If she wants to be taken seriously at future job interviews, we're going to have to graduate her style into something way more grown up.
I actually didn't mind Phoenix's androgynous cut, but I wanted to correct the colour and make her rise from ash blonde to sophisticated siren.
The white eyeliner and fake glasses were hiding Phoenix's natural beauty. I wanted to show her a few simple tips that will boost her confidence, but not take her too far out of her comfort zone. But have we done enough to turn her from faux toddler to fully grown adult?
Wow, wow, let me look at you.
Mmm, hot stuff.
No peeking.
Okay, so this is it.
Yeah, I'm a bit nervous.
You're nervous?
Yeah.
I can't believe it. I never thought you would have been nervous.
It depends on the situation.
Well, let's get on with it then. 3, 2, 1.
Oh my God! that's crazy. Don't know who that is. Who is that person?
Go have a look. Go have a close up.
Oh my God. Oh, I like my hair. I like the colour. Ooh, that's really cute. I like it.
I think this is where we start. This shape really works for your figure, and I think it looks fun and creative And when you walk in a room, you make an impression and people understand what you're about. I chose a graphic that was not too cute, but it was cute enough. It kind of references that sort of graph look. It's young, it's not an old lady floral.
I mean, it's really cute. I think the shoes are really cute. I'm keeping those. The dress, I'm going to admit, like, it's really not, like, me. I think it's a really cute design. It would look really cute on somebody else who is more confident in wearing something like this.
Right, so the hair, Daniel's kept it darker in the root and then lighter out. It's elfin, it's a pixie cut, and it goes really nicely with your dress as well.
Mm.
You love the hair, right?
I love the colour. It's really cute. I like how it's like darker and it goes lighter, and it's just like a really cute shape.
So Mel has put in a beautiful brow and just highlighted your eyes so you can really see them. The makeup works tonally with the outfit and the hair. How do you feel?
I don't feel like me at all. I'm sorry. But I think it's a really cute look and somebody else could really pull this off quite nicely.
I think you're pulling it off quite nicely. Do you remember before we got the public to rate your look and it was a really poor 2.9 out of 10? Well, we've asked them again. Do you want to see what they've got to say?
Let's do this.
She looks really, like, classic and, like, yeah, really beautiful. The makeup's amazing. Yeah, her piercings suit, like, with the makeup, they usually look quite harsh on people's faces, but it looks really sweet and, like, yeah, really lovely.
I think she looks really great. Her makeup's nice and her eyelashes are really good, quite long, quite cat-ish.
Yeah, I like cats, so I like that comment.
Oh my God! She doesn't look like her. I like the natural tones and how it really brings out her eyes. They're the first thing I notice.
My sister really likes natural makeup, so that doesn't really surprise me.
Oh, that's lovely. It's more mature and she's transformed from kind of an adolescent look to a woman.
I think that she would have a much better chance now of getting the good job that she deserves.
She looks amazing, like, definitely would rate her a 10 out of 10.
I would give this girl's look an 8 out of 10. She looks pretty fab.
I would rate my sister's new look a bajillion out of 10.
Thanks.
I would rate her new look more than 100%. She looks really, really beautiful and I'm really proud.
Oh, you've got to love making your mum happy, though.
Yeah, I do.
She said 100% hotter. And you do look 100% hotter. Do you want to know what your new average score is?
Sure.
It's a very improved 8.5 out of 10.
Cool. It's really nice that they feel that way, but it's kind of hard to take that as a personal compliment.
Why not? This is you. You're the one standing here looking beautiful.
Like, it's not personally something that I would wear, but I think it's like a really nice put together outfit and I appreciate like all the work that's been put into it.
Well, we came here to experiment a bit, to show you a different way. You might not think it, but we and the public think you look 100% hotter. Will you promise me one thing?
What's that?
You're gonna wear this to your first proper job interview.
Well, I mean, I have a job interview at a pastel alternative shop, so maybe not this one, but the next one.
Okay. Will you let me know how it goes then? Because I reckon you're going to kill it.
Sure, that'll do. Thank you for everything.
Oh, it's been a pleasure. Get out there, Phoenix, and fly.
Bye.
Still to come, will the style team's dramatic new look for door woman Abby finally put her on the VIP list?
Hi. Oh my God. I'm so scared.
Door woman Abby was like a burly blow-up doll when she first came in. Her dress could barely contain her boobs.
Abby's makeup masked her femininity. She wore huge false lashes and was a terrible shade of tangerine. I feel she was afraid to step out as her natural self.
For me, Abby's double weave meant double trouble. That fake peroxide hair was bright, brassy, and hiding a home dye horror story.
It's time to banish the Barbie bouncer and give Abby some style sophistication security.
Hi.
Oh my God. You actually look incredible. I can't wait for you to see yourself.
I'm so scared.
Don't be scared. Come over.
Okay.
You look so beautiful.
Thank
like
you, so
you actually
much.
Look so amazing. Can we make a deal?
Yeah.
if you think you look banging, can you twerk?
Okay, yeah. Let's do.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
There I go.
Oh my God.
I'm crying. Oh my God, I look so different.
You look insane. Just turn around for a second. Let me see that ass. Okay, yeah. literally, you look amazing.
I actually love it. I'm actually in love with it. I was really nervous at first, but now I'm obsessed with it.
What do you feel like?
More natural.
Yeah.
Which is so nice to not wear fake tan. I'm actually not as pale as I thought I was.
Not at all.
Which is quite nice. I'm actually over the moon.
So let's do a little breakdown of the look. Your skin looks flawless.
It's like, perfect.
Yeah, and I've kept it to your skin tone, but I've warmed it up with the contour and the bronzer. I wanted to define your lips in a natural way, make them look nice and juicy and plumpy.
Beautiful.
It's so nice, it suits you so much.
Makes them look so much bigger as well, which I absolutely love.
Yeah. And also with the eyes, can you see that they're not really overly made up? There's not loads of dark. I've just done a liner with lashes. It gives it that really like fluttery, pretty look.
Yeah.
And also you've got the fringe now. Daniel has killed it with the hair.
He has.
Hasn't he? Like giving you that fringe as well. You look so beautiful. He's given you kind of a Hollywood wave, easy to maintain. So when you are like restyling your hair, it's literally 2 seconds, give it a little blow, and then you can just tong it like he did.
Yeah.
And the color that it is now, it's also going to make your hair so much healthier.
Yeah.
And look, it looks amazing, this colour.
No,
you don't need
bleach.
To be...
No,
yeah,
more bleach.
No more bleach. You don't need to be blonde. Right, and now the outfit, which I love. Like, your figure.
So sophisticated.
Grace has put you in a really beautiful, classic black dress. You cannot go wrong with a black dress.
Mm-hmm.
It's the perfect length, so it's not showing too much.
Yeah.
But you've got a slit, which is nice because it still gives you a little bit of like sex appeal.
Yeah.
Your boobs are covered, which I really like.
Because you
look so classy, but you can see you've got boobs. You don't need them out.
I'm so shocked. I don't know how to react, but I'm so happy.
Right. Are you ready though? Because you know we rated you with the public. And you got a 4 out of 10.
Yeah, well, great.
Well, we have gone back to the public now with your new look.
Okay.
And we're going to see what they've said now.
Okay.
I think her hair's really, really nice colour. It definitely suits her complexion. Yeah, really nice natural look.
Yeah. I really like her wavy hair. It looks really like so
amazing, Daniel.
Thank you, Daniel.
The friend shapes her face really nicely.
Yeah.
Oh, she's so pretty. Brings out her eyes, like the makeup, the hair, just makes her eyes really pop.
I'd rate her look a 9. Solid 9.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
I would rate this girl 10 out of 10.
Woo!
I definitely would rate this girl a 9 out of 10. She's so pretty.
Wow.
So nice.
Wow. Oh, I like that. Hairstyle-wise, I like it. It makes her look, I think, probably how I'd like to see her. My Abby is stunning. 10 out of 10.
I think it'd be great.
I like it. Well done.
How amazing were those comments?
They were so nice.
And your dad, how'd you feel about
it? I know, it's so emotional.
So sweet.
It's so emotional. It's so nice hearing it from him.
It is. Like, it's just like you've got his approval now.
Yeah.
And you're so beautiful. And I feel like you needed to see it as well as everybody else. So
yeah.
I'm just happy that you can look at yourself in this way and be like, damn.
Finally happy.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Do you want to hear now what your new rating is from the public?
Yeah, I do.
9.5 out of 10.
Yes!
I'm so happy.
Twerk.
That's it. Yes. Oh, that's
how
amazing.
Good is that?
That is so good.
Like 9.5 out of 10.
That's amazing.
Girl. So I think you've gone now above 100% higher.
Yeah.
Yes. You're winning. You literally are winning in life. Thank you so much. Like, we've loved having you on.
Thank you so much.
No problem. So no more Barbie bouncer.
No more Barbie bouncer.
Thank you. See you, babe.
Since becoming 100% hotter, Abby has kept things covered up and held onto her darker locks, much to her dad's delight. Despite loving her new hairdo, wearing a dress wasn't for Phoenix. So she's decided to maintain her Japanese fairy kei style and is still hoping to land her dream job.